Gout was added to the list of hazards faced by heavy beer drinkers after an 18-month study of 61 patients. Dr. Gibson and five colleagues at Guy's knew drinks like port had long been suspected of bringing on gout, but now, after painstaking research, they point the finger at beers, though real ales and home brews are lesser offenders than the keg variety. It's all to do with how much of a chemical called purine they contain.
Because most people who enjoy drinking in this country consume beer in preference to other beverages, it's hardly surprising that we find this relationship with beer in the UK.
But you can actually draw a line between real ales then and keg beer.
Well, we have recently been measuring the amount of these purines in different beers. And although we're not absolutely sure of the contribution these make to the development of gout, we have been able to show that the purine content of beers varies quite significantly.
Beer drinkers don't seem unduly worried about the findings.
Well, I've never had gout, so it doesn't worry me, no.
On a pint a day, I wouldn't have thought that it made that much difference to gout, would you?
What do you think causes gout?
I.e. sherry, port, or perhaps wine, claret, or whatever. But beer, just cause you physical deformities, is the word.
Sadly, purine-free beer can't be produced without affecting the taste, so the doctor's suggested remedy to this new blow to heavy beer drinkers is cut down or suffer the consequences. Mark Wadsworth for Thames News.